The idea of protection is something that is negotiated and mediated over a long period of time, rather than evolving organically. Bo-Kaap is an example of this contradiction between preservation and change. In 2004, the South African Heritage Resources Agency listed the Bo-Kaap as a Grade 1 National Heritage Site.
The South African Heritage Resources Agency was established in terms of the National Heritage Resources Act and is mandated with the management of the national estate, which is heritage resources that are significant on a national level. The rarity of the Bo-Kaap is the community as a whole is extremely unique and attracts a host of local as well as international tourists. Days of fasting and feasting are of great importance and are celebrated in splendor within the community. It's an aesthetic value, of course. It has the largest concentration of pre-1840 architecture in South Africa. Examples of the architectural significance include houses in the old National Monuments area, and that's a section between Rose Street and Chiapini Street, as well as the Wales Street Museum. There's a spiritual value where numerous mosques and kramats and the quarry sites have spiritual significance. And it also has rich stories, legends, myths and values which adds to the living heritage that's passed on from one generation to another.
The idea is brilliant, but the way that it's being implemented would be, there could definitely be improvements.
We have lots of benefits in terms of heritage sites where tour operators come through our area. But the area is not benefiting, our people are not benefiting.
Basically, they are more interested in keeping or protecting the front facades of your property to basically have that same look as what it would have looked 200 years ago. You look at maintaining sash windows, it's not an easy feat, it's quite expensive. If you look at these moulding, it's not just an easy affair. You can't just call a plasterer to come and say, you know what, fix up the mould. It has to be someone that has dealt with it.
The sash windows, how much of sash windows cost nowadays?
Yeah, 2,000 rand.
Yeah, more than 2,000 rand a piece.
A lot of time people would want to comply with the legislation and they would want to comply with the processes, but they don't have the financial means to do so. So we try to assist them as best as we possibly can, but unfortunately the ideal world, we don't have the funding to assist them in that regard.
I can't see why the government can't step in to maintain the diversity within this neighbourhood and to maintain the cultural heritage that we have. And so I would call very strongly for government subsidies to these people. So you say, this is what I'm earning, that my wall's just fallen down. I'd like to have my wall rebuilt. And there should be some kind of... But nobody's thought of it. It hasn't come through.
That identity, that culture is being reshaped or remodeled is a better word, in order to turn it into an economic commodity, you know, in order for it to be sold on the market out there into a better and different product.
It was claimed that Bo-Kaap was always a colourful area. Was not so, in fact. It's only in the last 15 to 20 years. One person started painting a bright colour and soon others caught on.
And so the municipality paid for their houses to be developed along Wales Street. They were the ones that put up all these multicoloured houses. It wasn't part of the culture.
It was made like that because it could earn money for the city.
There's politics in tourism, and the problem that we've had as a community is that these buses stop. They stop for, like, literally give their people 10 minutes to take a walk from one, like, the most picturesque street in Bo-Kaap, and they get off at that point, walk across, and then they meet the bus at another point. That's it. Take some pictures, the tour guide probably says some words on the area, and they leave Bo-Kaap so they can say they've been in Bo-Kaap.
Hola.
Hola.
Sudáfrica. Cape Town. Estamos en...
Bo-Kaap.
Bo-Kaap.
For a casual stroll, check out the Bo-Kaap district. Now, the Bo-Kaap district has these beautifully colored painted houses on every corner with cobblestone paths. It's like a crayon box. It's spectacular.
Little boxes on the hillside. Little boxes made of ticky-tacky. Little boxes on the hillside. little boxes all the same. There's a pink one and a green one and a blue one and a yellow one, and they're all made out of ticky-tacky, and they all look...
The tourists never used to come into your house. We used to sit stand on the stoops and whatever, and they drive past with the buses, as you've seen just now, and we look like the monkeys. Hi! But now it's different.
You know, it's fine to say that the tourists aren't coming in here and we're not earning any money from them, but we weren't offering anything.
They're starting to interact with us. We have a meal together, we learn to get to know each other, and the community actually starting to benefit from it.
What is important about the Bo-Kaap heritage is not just the physical houses that's standing there, or the cobbled streets in certain parts of the area, or the shrine at the cemetery at the top. Those are sort of physical features, but it's the life, the living behind it all, and the connections and connectedness between that life and these physical heritage sites.
Doesn't mean because they make it heritage, it belongs to them. Oh no, doesn't work like that.
Amongst the kraal members, there are people that are from the area. I think there are about 10 families on the kraal that are from the area that, I mean, there's clear evidence that they are part of the community. Those 10 families, if there was low-cost housing allocated for them in the area, I know that all 10 of those families would very much happily move out of the kraal and move into low-cost housing in the area. But what council has done is they've offered them low-cost housing in Bel Air and I don't know where else.
Van hier gaan roppen en in de gesmokkelerij worry. Dit is als het klaar is dan gaan praten.
Oké. Ja. Oké, mijn naam is Kenneth Prins. I'm the spokesperson for the kraal and so it's okay, you can use this footage.
I actually wish for them to just build here for the people in Kenneth. You know them, and that's what more can I ask for. Give them where they want to be. You can't always have it, you know. But I heard what Helen Zilla said, I will never forget it, Helen Zilla said one day, give the people what they want. They want to stay there, both for them there. She heard it. The world is jealous for this ground. I'm being honest.